and hear from you, our Lord and our Father. God, teach us with a teachable spirit that we may understand your will and come near to you. In Jesus' holy name we pray and believe.
Amen.
Let's turn to our Bibles, the book of John chapter 8. We'll be reading from verse 1 all through to verses 10 and 11. But before that, let's remind ourselves with our memory text, which came from the book of John, chapter 8, verses number 10. Read it.
It says, when Jesus had lifted up himself and saw none but the woman, he said unto her, woman, where are those thine accusers? Hath no man condemned thee?
Yeah, this reminds me of one nice song I used to sing when I was a youth. Back then, Zamani Zangu Sio Zako Sawa. Back then, used to sing this song. If you know it, you can accompany me in singing at least a mouthful of it.
Nimeleta mwanamke kwa Yesu akisema kuwa ni mzinzi akitaka Yesu amhukumu. Waandishi na Mafarisayo nimeleta mwanamke kwa Yesu akisema kuwa ni mzinzi akitaka Yesu amhukumu. Kulingana na za Torati za Musa kata kama hili asali kupima mawe Yesu unasemaje?
So you know the song but you don't want to sing. Well, I know. Now, let's read from verses 1. Brother Norbert, I saw you are so sharp in reading. Read from verses 1.
From verse 1.
Yes.
Jesus went on to the Mount Olives, and early in the morning he came again into the temple, and all the people came unto him, and he sat down and he talked to them. Verse 3. And the scribes and the Pharisees brought unto him a woman taken in adultery, and when they had set her in the midst, they say unto him, Master, this woman was taken in adultery, in the very act.
And thank you. At least up to verses 4, sit down. Now, Jesus, after spending a good time in the day, went to his bedroom. Basically, in the Mount of Olives. I suppose it was an area like this, because it was not warm, it was cold. But Jesus said no otherwise. He still had to spend the night there. In the morning. In the what? He came out from that Mount of Olives with who? With his disciples. And where did they go? Where did they go? Into the temple. I suppose they went there to worship. But after reaching the temple, those elders, those priests, those dignitaries in the church, who are supposed to be carrying their Bibles, who are supposed to be dressed smart, who are supposed to be carrying their songbook, who are supposed to be carrying their hymnals, who are supposed to be carrying their Bible study guides, came carrying stones and who? A woman. And I just want to believe that they were not just telling her, situende. They were promoting her and coming. And then I just want to believe that Jesus was on the pulpit trying to give the word to the congregation. I'm trying to see that video where Jesus abruptly turned his face towards the people who are just marching, beating the woman, and then throws the woman. What? This Jesus, we found her in the very act. And then, like Jesus, I'll tend to face the other side and then think, these people are not normal. Jesus thinks that these people are actually not normal. In the very act, are you sure? Catching a woman in the very act in adultery, alone, My Bible tells me that they brought the woman alone. And tells Jesus, we found her in the very... Okay, if she was stealing, I would agree with them. If actually she was murdering somebody, I will still agree. If she was cursing somebody, I will still do what?
If she was drinking alcohol, I'll still do what?
If she was smoking, I'll still agree with them. But now, the point is that I don't agree with them. Adultery, alone. To make it matter worse, in the very...
And these people do not say she was masturbating. They say we got her in the very act of adultery.
Now, point number one. These people brought the woman and ignored the sins of a man. But all of them were sinners. Point number two. Where were these people early in the morning? Instead of preparing to go to church, where were they so that they found this woman? And I want you to believe that this woman was not on the roadside doing these activities. She was somewhere very secure since it is a mom. If she was a prostitute, she might have not had customers the previous night. But pengine mgeni moja amefika into the town, so this is a net catching fish in the mouth. I tend to believe some people somewhere might have been looking at this woman. Amepata customer, ndio amemwingiza lodging. Twendeni. Just match. Open this door. Ama tukuja na nini? That means they got the woman there. I don't know if the man ran away, but he could not have run because they got the lady in the very. So the man must have been gotten there. Now, who is a sinner here? Who is a sinner here? They have got a woman. By the way, these people, when they brought this woman, they wanted to justify themselves that simulona vile tuko holy mpaka hata tumempata. This reminds me one day in my village. There was a church elder. When the members are busy sleeping and even his family are busy sleeping, this man could roam around houses, widows' houses. And then he could go next to the window so that he can listen if there is some sound or some people talking inside, especially if there is a man talking in this widow's house. He could stay there for a long period. And if there is no man coming to this family, she could say she is clean. Then she goes to another widow's house. Then I'll ask myself, when does this man sleep? Is that the mission that God has actually given him? This reminds me of these same Pharisees. What were they doing? It seems to me that even maybe in the night, they were going from one house to another to see who is married and who is not. And if you are married, is your husband around? If the husband is not around, is there somebody else in the house so that you can corner him? By the way, the type of Pharisees is not different with our time today. The type of the Pharisees is like today. People are doing their sins openly. But people are keeping quiet. Because the mzee wa kanisa hautaongea. It might be that one of the men who was so serious with the stone,
here who wants to kill this woman might be the man, the same man who was caught with who? This woman. But because he was having a chair in the church, people don't know. Because he was maybe a governor in the village, people don't want to. You can imagine having a governor. Unataka kupeleka mtu kwa polisi. Atu amefanya makosa. And one of them is a governor. Unashika ule mwingine unachana na governor because you don't want trouble with him. Sometimes we fear telling people their sins because of how great they are. We don't want to corner some people telling them that this is sin because of the society they come from, because of the background we know about them, because of the position they hold in the school, because of the influence they hold in the village. This woman suffers alone, and they were sinning when they were two. There's another point here. The time of Jesus, there were religious giants. As we can see today, there are religious giants in the church. People who could not see their sins, who could see the sins of others and forget they are also sinners. Even today, there are those people who think themselves that we are holy, we are not sin. But 1 John chapter 1 verses 9 tells me that if we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves. But if we confess our sins, God is just and holy to forgive us our sins and our trespasses. These people, these Pharisees, these Sadducees were not ready. My brother and sister, they were not ready to repent. They were not ready to accept their mistake. They were not ready to see their sinfulness. And one thing the Bible shows is this. When they brought this woman, they brought her with accusations. They did not want to be corrected. They wanted to correct this woman. Not forgetting the book of Galatians, chapter number 6, verses 1. Our brother, read it for us. What does it say?
6:1 says,
yes.
Brethren, if a man be overtaken in a fault, you which are spiritual, restore such an one in the spirit of meekness, considering thyself, lest thou also be tempted.
Today, in the world, corrections are no longer there. You see, brother John, I did something bad. Watch out to Simuambia and Ezakwazo. I've been saying once and I've been saying always, and I continue to say that whenever somebody sins, it is better to be told that this is sin and you correct that person and he repents. Even in my workplace, I no longer correct the Adventist alone. Even all those that call themselves Christian wherever they are, I do correct them, telling them that this kingdom doesn't belong to me alone. It is not written the kingdom of Adventist. It is the kingdom of God. Mm-hmm. And all those who believe Jesus must have a ticket to where? To that kingdom of God. Sometimes you correct somebody and I can be like, you think you are holy. You think all those people who stand in front are holy. You see? Corrections are no longer available in the vocabulary of the church. Corrections is no longer anywhere. That people want to correct others and they don't want to be doer. To be what? To be corrected. It's a time that the church must wake up that when we are going out to tell people to come to Jesus, we must be ready to tell ourselves that we also have to go to who? Jesus. There was no single person among the Sadducees and the Pharisees who are taking this woman who was also taking himself to Jesus. That they also want Jesus to judge me according to his mercies. This reminds me of one thing. In the book of John, Luke chapter 19 verses 10, it reminds me of one thing. That God's mission was about to meet with the adulterous woman. This woman is brought. I see him, Jesus, trying to figure out what these people have in mind. trying to give them a chance to realize that my mission as Jesus is this.
Read 19:10 says, "For the Son of Man is come to seek and to save that which was lost." Continue.
The Son of Man came to do one thing here. One, to put a kidole, to do what? To save.
To seek.
Point number one, he came to do what?
To seek.
So, this adulterous woman that you people have brought before me, I came for her. Or people like her. Two, to do what? To save. Therefore, I'm waiting an opportunity to do her, to her, to save. But these people who brought this adulterous woman did not want to see the mission of Jesus. And if, and because they were blind to that mission, Yesu akainama. Verses 5, you are in the book of John chapter 8. You are in verses 5.
John 5 says,
it's 8:5.
8:5 says, yeah. Now Moses in the law commanded us, says this is now we are talking. Now Moses in the law commanded us that such should be stoned. But what says now?
Yes, Jesus is here trying to figure out his mission to the congregation, to the woman who is brought by Jessica, who has been brought down just to be judged by Jesus. Jesus is just trying to contemplate on his mission. But these people are pressing. According to the law, this woman needs to do what?
To die.
What do you say? Get that very quickly. We don't want to know about your mission. We want to sentence this woman. In the next few seconds, we want to sentence this woman to death. Just tell us about yourself. Like the scribes, or the scribes and the Pharisees, sometimes church leadership wanapiga vijana. You see, vijana are not that. You are tender dhambi sana. You are that church. When sometimes you try to come and sing, and they say, ah, wanaimba nini hapa, tokeni. You want youth to go to mission. Ah, yes, watenda wapende sharati kwa msiduni. You see, they are trying to classify youth as what? Sinners. The Bible doesn't say so. The Bible in the book of 1 John chapter 2 verses 3 and chapter 2 verses 13 and 14. 13, it says, I write unto you young men, because you have overcome him. Who? The devil. Go forward there in verse 14. I write unto you young men, because you know him. And the word of God dwells in you. But sometimes we tend to call others sinners. Not forgetting that it is the sinfulness of mankind that Jesus had to leave all the glory in heaven to come down where? Here. Jesus came to seek and to save that which was lost. Verse 6.
6 says, this they say, tempting him that they might have to accuse him. But Jesus stooped down and his finger wrote on the ground as though he had them know.
Yes. When these people are trying to pass their own judgment and waiting for Jesus to rubber stamp their judgment. On the contrary, Jesus doesn't rubber stamp their conclusions. In as much as in your village, in your school, in your surrounding, in wherever place you go, in as much as you try to say that these people are sinners, when you are coming this side, other people are going the other side. When you are coming with the joy of the Lord, other people are in their farms. We might try to say, those are sinners. In fact, those are the people that Jesus died for them. And when the Pharisees were trying to become so busy, waiting for Jesus to mention a word to stone the woman, Jesus pretended not to hear them. What did he do? He started writing on the ground. As if he never heard them. Verses 8. What does verse 8 say?
It says, and again he stooped down and wrote on the ground. And they say, which had it, being convicted by their own conscience, went out one by one, beginning at the eldest, even unto the last. And Jesus was left alone, and the woman
standing in the midst.
Thank you very much.
There are two points here. One, the woman is brought as accused, as guilty. He is brought by multitude before Jesus. And when he's brought by multitude before Jesus, Jesus alone was full of grace and mercy. So, it is luck that they did not stone this woman elsewhere. They brought him before Jesus. And not to stone him before who? Jesus. So, point number one is, whenever you are an accused, whenever you find yourself a sinner, the only place to be is in the presence of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen?
Amen.
Wherever you find yourself that you have fallen, you are a sinner. But before you find yourself a sinner, like the Pharisees, in the presence of God, in the presence of Jesus, you are not safe. But the moment you realize yourself that you are a sinner and stand before Jesus, oh, my brother, yes, my sister, you find yourself a sinner standing before Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You find yourself standing before Jesus, you are saved. Ah, let me repeat myself. Are you hearing from this corner? I'm saying, if you find yourself a sinner, let me make this sink down into your mind. Sometimes it is the Lord's Supper, it is the Passover of the Lord in the church. And then that table goes like this with white, whatever. It is the Lord's Supper. In fact, the right day for you to eat that Lord's Supper is not when you are holy, it is when you are a sinner. If you just wake up and take your possessions and leave the church, in fact, you do the worst thing to yourself. The right thing to do when you are a sinner is to stand before the Lord. Amen?
Amen.
Point number two.
The woman now herself, conscious of her own guilt and being in the hands of accusers
or those law enforcers, yeah,
had three questions to ask herself. Will they kill me? Will they stone me? Question number two. Will he accept the stoning? Will he also condemn me? Will they stone me? Will he also say that I'll be stoned? Will he condemn me? And the third question, will I die really? You have been asking yourself, maybe you do a mistake, you sin there and there, and then you ask yourself, actually, will this church really accept me? Will they accept me back as their member? Yes? Will I be accepted in the family of God? Question number two, you have been asking yourself, will Jesus accept me with this kind of life, really? With this lifestyle? With this thing that I've been smoking? With this thing that I've been drinking? With this thing that I've been eating? With this kind of dressing? With this kind of makeup? Will Jesus really accept me? Oh, will he really accept me? You have been asking yourself a third question. Oh, will I die like this? Will I die a sinner? Will I really go to heaven? All those questions, when you stand before Jesus, there is one thing. We are in verse what?
Verse 10. Yes. It says, when Jesus had lifted up himself and saw none but the woman, he said unto her, woman, where are those that accuse us?
Thank you very much. Now, join this after asking. Jesus is with the woman. He asked, where are thy accusers? Now go to verse 6, and then I link something.
Verse 6, they say, tempting him, that they might have to accuse him. But Jesus stooped down, and with his finger wrote on the ground, as though he had heard them not.
Sometimes we think that Jesus will meet, or actually will help us, with what seems to be the need.
Jesus doesn't answer what seems to be the need. He answers the need. In fact, when these people were coming, they wanted to tempt Jesus. That is what they seems to be the answer. If Jesus come out of his temptation, now Jesus doesn't answer their need. Jesus answers what is the real need. The question of your heart. It's not a question of, am I doing the right thing? Am I judging rightly? No, it is. The question is your heart right? Look at this woman. She doesn't stand. She's there looking down, waiting for the first stone to land on her face, head, back, whichever side. She said, oh my God, this is my last day. But when Jesus asked them, if you don't have any sin, be the first to throw the stone. I see this woman doing this and waiting for the last first stone to land on where? On her. And then the stone doesn't land. And then what she hears? And when she hears the footstep, she doesn't hear the footstep coming next to her. But she hears the footstep disappearing what? Into the horizon. This woman is relieved to hear one question. Woman? Yes? Where are thine accusers? That is the point she realized. She was alone. With who?
Jesus.
Alone in his presence. She turns back and, Lord, they are not there. That did anyone condemn you? No. So, the first question that was she was asking, will they, has been deleted permanently. Now, two questions are still remaining. Will he condemn me and will I die are still in her face. Now, Jesus tells her who? What?
Says, yes. Has no man condemned thee?
Yes.
She said, no man, Lord. Yes. And Jesus said unto her, neither do I condemn thee. Go and sin more.
Thank you. Neither do I do what?
Condemn you.
So, second question, will he condemn me? The answer is, that question is deleted. It is not answered. It is deleted. All together, Jesus doesn't answer those questions. He deletes the questions. Will they condemn me? The answer is not even they will or they will not. The question is, it is deleted. That question is deleted. It is no more because those people are no more. If they were there still standing and did not throw the stone, the question would have been answered. But now the question has been deleted. Because Jesus did not answer the question to the Pharisees, that question also is deleted from Jesus' side, that he doesn't condemn, he doesn't answer the woman that I will condemn you. So one question remains, will I die? The woman here came with three questions. Will they condemn me? Will Jesus condemn me? And will I die? Now, these two questions have been deleted. One last question still remains. But Jesus says, neither do I condemn thee. Go and sin no more. Go and sin no more. That means I am free. Will I die? And that is not answered. What is answered is, go and sin no more. So, I am indeed free. All those questions have been deleted. My brother and my sister, you might be having some things that have been bothering you in your life, in your private life, back there, before you came here today. And they were even bothering you when you came into this room. And they were even bothering you when you started talking. But let me assure to you, all those questions are now deleted.
Amen.
When you are alone with Jesus, not Jonah, when you are alone with Jesus, all those questions have been deleted. Jesus has one word for you.
go and sin no more. Now, how do we go alone to be with Jesus? Book of 1 John, chapter 1, verses 8 and 9. How can we stand alone with Jesus?
1 John 2, 9. It says, 1 John 2, 9 says, He that saith he is in the light and hateth his brother is in darkness, even until now.
Which book did you read?
1 John.
Chapter?
That is chapter 2. So 1 John 2, 9.
I said 2. Yeah, now read what I said because I do not repeat this. And righteousness. Sit down. Everybody has read that part. Now my problem is, if I don't want to realize that I'm a sinner, will I confess? It is until I realize my filthiness, my inability to save myself, until I realize how bad I am, until I realize how my thoughts are, until I realize how my eyes are, until I realize how my character is, until I realize how my dressing code is, until I realize the drunkenness that I am in, until I realize the backbiting that I do, until I realize the lust that is in me, is then and then will I do what? Confess. Sorry? It is until I realize the mistakes that I have, that is the time I will confess. And when I confess, God is just and faithful to forgive us all our sins. But the time that I say I am okay, I am clean, I am well, I am a good Christian, Jesus will not forgive me. But the only time to get in to the presence of Jesus is to confess. Back in verses 10, when Jesus had lifted up himself and saw none but the woman, he said unto her, Woman, where are those thine accusers? Who are these accusers? Had no man condemned thee? What are these things that condemn us right now and today? What are those things? There is pride that is always accusing us. There is social misconduct that is always accusing us. Brother Nobert, ninaona msichana huko nje si anapendeza ni kama nyanya bwana. Na ni kama apple zenye zimemwagiwa maji maji hivi kidogo. Brother Ken, zikikaa hivi. Alafu sinineza nineza mali alafu nikamlete kanisani. This is social misconduct. Those are the accusers now here. You see? Hata kama kina brother so and so panda hanioni, ladies. Hanioni sasa hawatuoni wanaume wa kanisani hawatuoni. Sasa kama nikivaa hivi hanioni sinaleta kidogo juu. Sasa kama hanioni sinaleta kidogo juu. Sasa kama hanioni, imagine. Brothers, munakapa karibu na kwa accused na accusers. Why do they think our need is to be accused? Alafu anaka. Alafu unapata ya kwamba, alipovaa dress kama angalia umekaa na huyu na hujamwambia hata ako beautiful. Do you want accusers to accuse her? Alafu kesha akivaa size ya hii koti yangu, akivaa size ya hii koti yangu, kule nje, a man, I'm not talking about Christianity, I'm talking about men. A man outside now, alafu anamwambia you are beautiful. Tena kama ako beautiful atua hivi, mbona asivai kwa kita kanisani ndio? Angalau, brother mbaba atamuona amwambia you are beautiful, and he still don't believe. Our accusers here are lukewarmness. That we no longer see Christianity as valid. Kama kuna mpira pale na kuna kanisani pale, one day I went to Masemara University, and it happened that there was Mrs. No, not Mrs. Miss. Miss. Mrs. Masemara. You can imagine how that day was so beautiful. It was an evening in the back. You could find half of the room and there and have her here. God can do it. But you invent in your lifetime event, Wana. So I better watch today. He said, si kwani kwani sabato inenda? Si kwani itakuwa? Kwani sabato itakuwa? So we tend to run to other things first and leave God alone. My brothers, my sister, who are these accusers of yours?
Nini nisi vitu zinakufunga funga? Why are you being tied by these Pharisees around you? Come to Jesus and say, Yes, jameni, imenisumbua. Yes, what do I do? I'm a sinner, I've come there. Ah, yes, nimekuja. Si ukuja tu kwani atakuchapa?
One question will remain. He will ask you, like verses 11, go and sin no more.
God doesn't say you sinner.
No. He didn't say you adulteress. No. He said, woman. You see, when Jesus was in the garden with Mary Magdalene, he said, woman, what are you looking for?
But this time around, he doesn't say, woman. He said, woman, where are thine accusers? He realized that this woman needs to be modeled. He's ashiko pole pole. Akwe handle carefully. Yesu ukija kwake ndugu yangu anakuhandle carefully. Amina. He is not arrogant. He wants to handle you in a soft manner and tells you, go and sin no more. Jesus is not talking like John, the way Jonah is talking. Jonah is talking just like that. But Jesus is saying, go and sin no more. Do you have time to be with us today? Do you want to come unto him?
I said, I'm saying this, brothers and sisters, Jesus is all loving. He came to seek and save that which was lost. And I like the way Paul puts it very clear that it's in 1 Corinthians 15:2. He says, this is a what? A good saying, worthy of acceptance. That Jesus came into this world to save who?
See what I'm saying, so you see what that sounds like.
Do you read in Swahili or in English? Which one is very sweet?
English.
You are not there.
First John 1:15.
Did I say John?
First Timothy.
So much.
In a sermon, this is a faithful saying.
And this is a faithful saying. And worthy.
And worthy of all acceptation.
Yes.
That Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am.
Not you. Me. So it was my verse. So sit down. That was Malizia. Of whom? You mean in a Malizia. But a Malizia, but if you are. And that's why I did not want it to be read. I wanted to. This is a faithful saying worthy of all acceptance. That Jesus came into this world to save who?
Sinners.
Of whom? Jonah. Of whom Jonah is the chief. See a chief or area? Chief of sinners. Yeah? Yani, hili ni neno la kuaminika, tena la stahili kukubalika, ya kwamba Yesu Kristo alikuja ulimwenguni kuokoa wenye dhambi. Na ya kuwa mimi Jonah.
Hata nataka
those sinners that realize that they are sinners. We want to come before Jesus to be a wachana na accusers. The problem is accusers of the devil. Ay, kumate. Hata ni vizuri ameenda kuokoka. Shauri ya accusers. Accusers utabebana nao. The goodness is, accusers unapokuja, wanaandamana nayo na macho. Unapokuja hata macho yao pia inakuja. Alafu waone kama Yesu atakupiga nini. Na? Utakuja, si hata mimi nimekuja. Sasa tewe utakuja, accusers wako atakuangalia. Aseme, angalia hata akule maana. The goodness is, when Jesus will start writing somewhere around our hearts, those accusers will disappear. You will not chase them. Amen?
Amen.
You will not chase them. They will just disappear by themselves. When Jesus says, you also have done some sin. But I now call upon you, brothers.
If you have listened to this one and you realize in your life you need some things to mend, you need some accusers to get away from your life and sin no more, please run, run here. You tell Jesus you have come. I say that I am the chief. Maybe you are the sub chief, but I am the chief. Maybe you are there.
In the when Jesus is calling, calling for you and for me. One you daddy and hero is mercy. Mercy for you and for me. Come on, come on. He who are weary, come on. Honestly, tenderly, Jesus is calling, calling for sinners, come on.